keep them there, they'll be hard to miss.
Good of Corypheus to make it easy to find him. If he's hiding in the Arbor Wilds, that's where we finish him.
But what is Corypheus doing in such a remote area?
His people have been ransacking elven ruins since Haven.
I think we're about ready to do that.
He seeks more. What he hopes to find, however, continues to elude us.
Which should surprise no one. Fortunately, I can assist.
You know, chat, Morgan, sense of style and fashion, you don't mess with the best. Please continue.
You have my attention, Lady Morrigan.
What Corypheus seeks in those Forgotten Woods is as ancient as it is dangerous.
Which is?
Tis best if I show you.
Is she talking about her child? The child of destiny? Oh my god, am I gonna get a continued of
this? This is an Illuvian. An elven artifact from a time long before their empire was lost to human greed. I restored this one at great cost, but another lies within the Arbor Wilds. That is what Corypheus seeks.
An elven artifact?
This belonged to my people.
Three Inquisitor quests left?
I found
okay.
Legends of an elven temple within the Arbor Wilds, untouched. It proved too dangerous to approach, and thus I turned elsewhere to find my prize. If Corypheus has turned southward, he could succeed where I failed. The Illuvian would be his.
What does it do?
A more appropriate question would be, where does it lead?
Oh, we're going in, chat. Oh, we're going in now. Do we not want friends? Back up, if you will. Strength in numbers, yes? No? Okay. I mean, we do have Morrigan. More than a badass, but yeah. Sadly, I didn't get to sell anything. I should sell before I do the war table. My bad. Getting that habit.
If this place once had a name, it has long been lost.
Yes! We did a complete playthrough, including DLC for Borderlands 1. It's all currently on YouTube right now. Cut to 30 to 45 minute segments.
A place where all Illuvians join, wherever they might be.
This could be useful.
A useful trick.
For one who knows the way, certainly.
Never know the way.
The elves left no roads, only ruins hidden in far-flung corners. This is how they traveled between them. As you can see,
hello, morning.
The mirrors are dark.
Been overrun by tiny children watching two more kids because my mom is in the at the doctor's. Sorry.
Can be opened from this side, but only a few.
Have you tried, putting them in a small little box with a playpen? Are they too big for that? How'd you find this?
How did you find out about this place?
My travels have led me to many strange destinations, Inquisitor. Once, they led me here.
A grade school, okay.
It offered sanctuary.
Have you tried bubble wrap?
Not all the mirrors lead back to our world. The ancients were nothing if not resourceful.
What does that mean?
If they don't lead back to our world, then...
Places between, like this one. I can describe it no better. For a time, I had a respite with the man I loved. For a time, I had a safe place to raise my son.
Oh my god,
only
this is...
for a time. One cannot remain in between forever.
Okay, so where am I at? Where's our son?
What do you mean, a few can be opened from this side?
Some of the Illuvians have been left unlocked, like doors accidentally left ajar. All others are closed. They can be opened only from beyond.
Opened how?
With a key.
How are, by the way? I'm good. Yeah, I'm good. I'm doing good. Kind of excited because everything that we did in Dragon Age Origins and Awakening is finally coming back through in Inquisition. And because it's been 11 years, hasn't it? Cause it's been 10 years plus the year that we had in Inquisition. So I have an 11-year-old boy running around and I have no idea where my character's at. So I don't want to know where this is going. Also, kind of excited because Friday, Doom! That should be painful. You have a key.
I suppose you have such a key.
The key can be many things. Each Illuvian is different. I have knowledge as well as power. Often that is enough.
Which, actually, if I remember correctly, Willow, your birthday is the 22nd. Is that Friday? Not good with my days. Is that Friday? That's 22nd. Oh, Sunday. Okay, so we'll probably play Doom Friday, Saturday, and then a little bit on Sunday, and then play a spooky game, aka Coma 2, for your birthday. I'm excited about Friday for Animal Crossing. I'm hearing that it is a chill game for an unchill time, which is good timing for Nintendo. Corypheus wants this.
Corypheus wants to come here.
This is not the Fade, but it is very close. Someone with enough power could tear down the ancient barriers.
And enter the Fade in the flesh, like Corypheus wanted to do with the Anchor.
He learned of the Illuvian in the Arbor Wilds as I did. He marshals the last of his forces to reach it.
Okay, so we gotta protect this place. Yes?
You have made Corypheus desperate, Inquisitor. We must work together to stop him, and soon.
I mean, if the shoe fits, Willow. Shoe fits. We don't know how devious Tom Nook couldn't really be, and choose to be. I mean, that little asshole of a raccoon. And I've never even played Animal Crossing, but I've had girlfriends talk about it in, like, almost. It's the way that I've had past girlfriends talk about Animal Crossing and Tom Nook, it's almost as if they, like, Tom Nook assaulted them, their family, like, their entire existence. Like, there's just a level of anger and or hatred that is almost irrational. Almost. Return to the war room to confirm the plan of attack. Okay. He does run a mafia. Yeah, see? Now, I mean, if Tom Nook actually threat upgrade. Upgrades the garden by committing the space to simple greenery and cultivation. A functional change that allows more herbs to be harvested. Upgrades the garden to a chantry, bringing hope to all who seek it. A functional upgrade that brings a potential resource gained from the inspired, including gold from ties. Garden. Where wither grows the simple scent of sprigs, a new and furrowed soil. Where on the vine are yours and mine, a bounty blessed by honest toil. Though brave in war and ways are we are, wander thus in victory. It's on the vine where yours and mine are, graced with health and history. In home and hearth and battlefield, our sustenance is common fate held. If on the vine are yours and mine, and always there we are compelled. Returning home is not retreat when home is why we fight at all. And on the vine is yours and mine, entering, entreating in our heart the call. Cool. Do I have ghouls? Beard, royal elf roots. Let's go with ghouls. Oh. Okay. And then we go over here. And... okay. Right. And then we will go royal. All right. And then out of curiosity, Arbor, Blood, Deep. I'm gonna wait. Or I'm not, it's gonna choose for me. Okay. Ooh, you know, we haven't really done this. Probably should go take a look at the alchemical stations and see about upgrading some potions, yes? Haven't done that in a while. Where? Ah, the Undercraft. Okay. I'm just gonna change the decor just a little bit. I want to see if we can get something a little less. I mean, it wasn't as bad as before. Okay, super gaudy before, but just a little bit less. Hey, I'm sorry. Did we just get a schematic? Hang on, chat. Heavy armor of the dragon. Heavy. Oh. Okay. Hold on. Hold on. Here. Yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh. That looked good on him, chat. That looked damn good on him. Man nips. Now, if you get faint in chat, right, if you get a little woozy, it's okay. Just fan yourself, chat. Just fan yourself. If you're a fan of Iron Bull or any other characters, just fan yourself. It's okay. It's okay. No shame in this chat. Tier 3 schematic, though. This is awesome. This is exactly what I need. Question is... let me take a look at Blackwall. I gotta show his man nips, right? That'd be weird. I mean, oh! Like seeing your uncle's man nips, and you're just like, ah, oh, that's a thing. Like when you go from an attractive cousin to your uncle, or from an attractive cousin to your aunt. That is extremely weird. However, the armor rating is what I'm looking at. That's the thing, because armor rating on this is decent, but this is just so much better. I don't think there's anything... That's pretty much it right there, yeah. Because remember, we have a Fade Touch... good brandy point here. Oh. I'm sorry, what? Critical crafting chance, 40%. 100% chance of masterwork, 10% to stats on success. Oh. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Oh, ho, ho. On kill, 20 magic, 20 to magic for 10 seconds. That's not bad. That's actually really not bad. Ability costs 7.5% less stamina mana. Chance to use hidden blades on hit with 4 added hits. Chance to inflict chain lightning damage. Okay, so this is the thing that we're looking for. Unbowed on a hit. Does anyone know what unbowed is? 2% chance to use unbowed on a hit. I have no idea what that means. Like, I am completely oblivious to that. Alright, so we have armor. Tier 2, tier 2. I need more dragon bow! Damn it. Everites, iron. You know, I know a good spot for some tier 3 silverites. I know a place. Love putting hidden blades on one weapon. It's great for getting through guard. Hidden blade. I mean, chat. 2% chance to sunder target on hit. 1 con and 1 strength. 4% fire damage resist. Constitution, armor penetration, and health. Strength con, chance to stagger on hit. Chance to stagger attacker on being hit. If I could figure out where I can get some more Dawnstone, I think that'd be the preferred. Even though Dragonbone gives us quite a bit of armor. Also, we did not get a whole lot of Dragonbone. Now that I think on it. Do you only get Dragonbone from a dragon? Or can I get it from the little, like, dragonlings, like the little guys? Because we could probably go farm them real quick. Or we could go hunt for another dragon jet. It just depends on what gives us dragon bone. Which would be easier to give us a confirmed dragon bone. I don't want to waste the spade touch. It took so long to get. Magic defense, barrier bonus. Nope.
Ooh.
Sold at Empyrean's crafting materials in the Black Emporium for 250. Dragonbone. Ooh. One magic, one willpower, right? It's not really a whole lot of, like, other than dragon webbing. That's all willpower. Why is this all magic based? Low power and I only seem to have, well, I guess willpower would help him, right? Strength. Holy crap, that's a lot. Ooh, okay, okay. It's not much difference between, is that Silverite? No. Cryophyte? 2.5% damage to guard, though. Okay. Cold resist. This dragon skills get him cunning and dexterity. Armor penetration, though. chance to sunder target on hits. Okay, so his dex. I know this is gonna lose. Let me take a look at attributes here. Character's intelligence and deviousness. Each one increases critical chance and defense. Critical chance and ranged defense. Okay. Each one increases attack and magic defense. Okay. Each one increases attack and critical damage. Oh, so only critical damage. So cunning would work really, really well. Okay. Hang on. There's more goodies we can craft. Let me see what we can craft. Apparently, I don't have a whole lot of options for helms. I don't know why. Why is that? Just... I mean, for a mage, you have almost nothing in the arms. But he has been working hard on that 8-pack, chat. Can't see it, but there's an extra level right there. Extra level, boom. Okay, let's take a look at crafting weapons here. Main sword. Haven't really gone up, have we? Eh? Masterwork inscribed axe, not bad. Oh. Okay. What level is that? Okay, so here's the kick. Chance to inflict chain lightning damage, 75% power. I have something. Chance to use hidden blades on a hit with 4 added hits. Okay, so now let me. If I put Fade Touch Ring Velvet on a 2-handed weapon, that means that when he strikes, I get 4 hits. Or does it do 4 additional, like, 4 times the damage? Don't forget that you don't get every single benefit from the craft materials. You only get the one that corresponds with the slot you're filling. Okay. Oh, okay. Got it. So, is that how 10% chance to use hidden blades on a hit? Is that with a 4 added hits? 4 added hits. Not getting how that weapon works. 10% chance to inflict chain lightning power at 100% damage power. That's not bad. 10% chance to use unbowed on a hit. There's a 10% chance that separate attack to go off. Okay. So if I hit it, anyone can use it. Okay, so it's not delegated to just a rogue. Got it. All right, so if I look at this, it's going to give us... Cotton will give us, right off the bat, 9% heal. And this is a offense. So I'm only looking at the offense, what it's going to do in general. Area damage bonus. Chance to heal on kill. Critical damage. Barrier damage. Attack. Oh, okay. Somehow I was looking at all of them being like, ooh. Okay, never mind. 11% on kill. Or 21% critical damage bonus. I think I'd go with the 21% critical damage bonus because the faster they die, the less I have to worry about said barrier. Armor penetration. Okay. I think now I'm starting to get this a little bit more. Superb Staff of the Dragon. Ooh, now that looks pretty good. All right, now we have... on kill. I put that on. And then we start fire damage. 56, 58... Oh, silver counts as cold damage, huh? If you really want to get fire damage, which almost seems essential for some things because of those damn despair demons, gotta heal some dragons. Like, a shit ton of dragons. Okay. All right. Anything for shield? Oh, God, that looks terrible. Okay, let's change the Skyhold to core. No, the crafting in this game is fantastic. Like, kudos to them for just nailing the crafting. Let's try the free marches. Do we have a new throne? One that does not look so damn gaudy? Okay, upgrade potions. We've only upgraded them once. Prophet's Laurel and Imbirium. Regeneration. Well, the good thing is we have enough Royal Elf Root. Lyrium Potion. I just need Elf Root. That's it. Tears of the Dead. Confusion Grenade. Jar of Bees. Witherstock. I haven't come across. Dragonthorn and Blood Lotus. Okay. Playing KOTOR Remake with this crafting system. Not just for lightsabers. Imagine. Because, okay, I'm going to be. This crafting system is identical to the Star Wars Galaxy's MMO crafting system, where you had tiers, quality to materials, and then sockets and mods and all sorts of things. And then even when you made the gear, your skill in crafting that gear increase the chance. So the better you are, you got a better version of that compared to other people who just were starting out, right? And it also helped that it put your name on the gear, so it incentivized people to go to, like, I'm gonna go to Paladin because she has the best, like, composite gear in all of the server, and she just knows what she's doing. And stuff like that. I want to see more RPGs. It's so good. But if they do KOTOR again, and the rumor is true, guns, lightsabers, armor, you name it, HK-47, go for it. Like, have a droid upgrade system where, like, you can, the better you are at engineering, there's so much stuff you could do. So much stuff. Okay, so we're going to go to the Black Emporium real quick. I want to see how much it's going to be for Dragonbone and how much it's going to be for Dragon Webbing. Because I'd like to make one good defensive armor set for Blackwall. Seen the pleasure of using? Yep. It's so rare that going around and finding like a resource gets you excited. Or finding a new recipe gets you excited. Because typically, you see a new recipe or a new resource you gotta farm, you're like, ah! Hi. Now it's like, ooh, what can I make out of that? What does the color look like? What are the stats? What are the bonuses? What's the tints? What's the hues? I have requests for information on your lineage from a few interested parties. What pride rot? And trust 40 power, me. Wow.
Feel free to use those requests as kindling.
No, I shall take them. I want to know who pines for our commander. We can use this to our advantage.
I am not bait.
You're bait, Colin.
Just look pretty.
just look pretty, Colin. It'll be fine. Be moody. People will love it. They'll fawn over you and be like, aww. It's worked to my tactical advantage. Would have been offensive armor for Iron Ball. Well, thing is, I want to make something first for Blackwall. Because he's right now the one that's staying up, holding up, and keeping everyone's attention. He's actually turning out to be a really, really, really good tank. Then we worry about Iron Ball, and then we probably worry about Vivian, and then we worry about me. Oh, hang on. Honey? Wait, what's going on? Hold on. Thanks, Isaac. EA help. Respond to my tweet and they're like, you're going in nightmare mode and blind? Oh, that should be fun. Thanks, Isaac. Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it. Love you. Miss Pierce, hey, morning. You can pick Animal Crossing tomorrow? Wait. How can you break the laws of thermodynamics and the laws of temporal mechanics? Thermodynamics. Don't even know why I applied that. Temporal mechanics. Are you ahead in the future? Bloodstone's still my favorite color. I mean, it's Bloodstone. It's blood red, right?
Urchin, bring me a moist towelette.